I dream of a world free from pain and suffering, a world free of chronic degenerative disease.
I see the city lights all around me. Everyone's obscure. 10 million people, each with their problems. Why should anyone care?
I knew I had to do something. However small, I knew I had to do something. The cell is the basic unit of life. It's a miracle.
Optimal nutrition at the cellular level had the potential for preventing and even reversing degenerative disease. True health is not just the absence of disease. It is empowering our bodies to perform at their optimum level.
I'm very excited about this partnership because we are talking the same language, we have the same goals and the same mission, and to help each other achieve that mission, I think, is very exciting for all of us.
In June 2007, he was presented the Albert Einstein Award for Outstanding Achievement in the Life Sciences.
The Albert Einstein Award was a great honor for a great man. You know, I've worked with other world-renowned scientists like Dr. Jonas Salk, as well as world-class athletes, Apollo astronauts, and countless Fortune 500 top executives. However, Dr. Myron Wentz may be the most impressive person that I've ever met.
A man whose life's work has resulted in yet another new horizon, a new dawn for the health of mankind, is Dr. Myron Wentz. His work in the areas of virology, immunology, and nutritional science have impacted scores of lives across the globe.
I learned to persist when I believed I was correct, despite the criticism of others, especially those in positions of authority. My father was highly regarded as a man of generosity and compassion. Years later, when I was coming home from college and would stop by a farm or store in our area, all I had to do was mention that I was Adam Wentz's son, and they would roll out the red carpet for me. It seemed that everybody I met had been a recipient of my father's help or generosity, or that they simply had a great deal of admiration and respect for him. That made it even harder to have lost him when I was 17. He died at 57 from heart disease, which he had lived with as far back as I can remember, having spent time in hospitals and long-term care facilities. I believe that some of my drive to contribute to society can be attributed to a desire to compensate for his loss and to be worthy of his respect as he was respected by others. We need to take charge of our own health and determine our own fate. We need to embrace, on a personal level, the principles of preventive health care. We need to adopt the lifestyle elements that are now known to dramatically reduce the risk of chronic degenerative disease. We need to start today. And just as important, we need to encourage our children, our siblings, our parents, and our friends to do the same. Making a lifelong commitment to health means making the pursuit of health a way of life. And I remain optimistic that most people who develop a true passion for health will find a method that works for them. This optimism is fundamental to my dream of a world free of pain and suffering, a world free of chronic degenerative disease. Take charge of your health. Share my vision. The greatest invisible miracle of all is the existence of life itself.